Shandobra, everyone. Welcome to the Game Grid, and... Wow, I forgot to add that particular costume on. Welcome to the first 10 minutes of LittleBigPlanet 2. Yeah, you probably saw this coming. Yep, it's pretty much exactly the same as LittleBigPlanet 1, just... new and improved. Improved in quite a huge amount of ways, actually. Still has to load things, though.
That is how to get to the quarter.
Whoa, who is this, and why is he not made of cardboard? Well, he kind of is, but... yeah, basically, this game just added so much things. And it's pretty much the same basics. Pretty much. License to Thrill, huh? But yeah, always gotta start with the tutorials. Yep. Yeah, all these bubbles are empty because this was my test run playthrough. I got surprisingly far with just a single controller. And yeah, like I was saying with the first 10 of LBP1, it's gonna be a near as complete as possible playthrough. Some prizes you just literally cannot get without multiple controllers, but I will do my best. Airy leg, ew. Oh. Messy and cheese. Onwards for Craft World. Oh. This is fun. Yep. Bouncing all over the place. For some reason, the controller vibrates in this exact location, like, as if you're close to hazard. Never figured that out. Maybe it's a failsafe underneath to prevent getting stuck or something. Yeah, enormous bookcase, right, Da Vinci?
If you're one of those techno Trevors who knows absolutely everything.
Oh yeah, this was one thing that I missed in the first 10 of LBP1. Stephen Fry narration.
Of anything with your PlayStation Eye camera.
This is actually super important to the series.
I'm shaking too. Open your poppet with the menu button and go to the PlayStation.
Yeah, we're already 3 minutes in. We're just gonna move on. But yeah, just remember, Stephen Fry is very important in this game. Yeah, skip. What did that link screen say about LittleBigPlanet.com? We're actually gonna skip ahead a few. Now this one level I haven't 100%ed because some parts do outright require multiple controllers. Because you gotta be grabbing things simultaneously or something. Yeah. Yeah, I wonder what that switch trigger does. Oh, that wasn't aligned. Ooh, advanced mode. Yeah, things are a lot more dynamic in this game. OEP1 was basically like proof concepts, but they really went hog wild in this game. What in the net was that? Okay, that's creepy. Mind the lecture zappies down there. Case in point. Supposed to be saying something here, but I guess because it's in repeat playthrough mode. Ludicrous speed! Go! There's secrets up here. Am I supposed to be on this play, right? I don't recall. Bravery test indeed, concerning all the electricity around. Yep. Yeah. Definitely not doing that. Yeah, you can solve a bunch of the two-player areas just by hitting the PlayStation button and changing controller number, all that stuff. In fact, in the first game, that's actually a requirement of the 100% speedrun, because you can only use a single controller for that. Oh, one last challenge, huh? Let's just skip ahead. Yeah, I'm surprised to find out there actually is no 100% challenge for LBP2, like, no speedrun for it. Apparently, this game, you just genuinely can't get 100% with only one controller. Biv. Audio lag there. Alright, with 2 minutes left in the video, bell routine set. Whoa. Oh, button. Okay. If you're on the side over here, the thing just barely can't get you. And button. Keep hiding. Whoa. Got me. Yeah, it's all about timing and surviving this one. Oh, hey, grappling hook. But yeah, definitely doing a full playthrough of this game eventually. After LBP 1, of course. Got him. So yeah, look forward to that. He pulled me into the cutscene.